In this video, you'll learn how to add a dialog view to a project as a custom control. Start by navigating to Microsoft Visual Studio Code. To create a dialog control, we'll need to work with a few files in our project. These files are necessary to set up the dialog, define its layout, and handle its events. Let's look at each of these files. The first is the dialog layout. This is a JSON file that will describe the structure of the dialog window. The second file is the dialog logic. This is a JavaScript file that will contain all the logic of the dialog window. The third is the manifest.json file. This file is used to store configuration and metadata in the project. In this file, we will declare our new dialog view. The last file is the JavaScript for the main view, which contains the dialog instance, including the button click event for this dialog. Let's go to the dialog layout. We can divide this file into three parts. The first part contains all the parameters for this dialog window, for example, the type, the title, and the controller related to this layout. There are also other properties such as draggable and resizable. Let's see what these properties look like in the web client. Let's try to drag it. Then let's try to change the size of the window. Let's go back to Visual Studio Code. The second part is the form containers, which includes all the controls inside. In our case, it's a very simple one with just a text area control. So we have the label of the text area, the control type, and the value of this control. The last part is the footer bar, which in our case contains two buttons, OK and Close. In addition to the button type, each button has its own proc name for Close, the Close action, and for OK, the OK action. All the logic of this proc can be found in the controller of the dialog. Next, let's go to the dialog JavaScript that contains all the logic of this dialog. You can see that we have the onDataLoad function. This function, with the active view, creates an empty data source named demo. The next thing to do is access the text area control by its ID, which gets the context parameter pass from the parent view, which in this case is the sales quotation. The last thing to do here is populate the text area with its context data. Other functions that you can find in the controller are a close action, which will close the current dialog window, and the OK action. In the OK action, there are two parts. The first part is retrieved, the MyTextArea control and its value. And the second part is validate the input. If there is an empty input, a pop-up warning message will appear. Otherwise, it will close the dialog window and return the value. Let's see it in the web client. I'll change the value of the text area, and it shows a pop-up message with the return value. Let's go back to the sales quotation layout. This layout contains the structure of this view. In our case, we have two buttons, Get Company Information and Show Dialog. The Show Dialog button contains its own properties like text and tooltip. In addition to this, we have the function name onOpenDialogClick. Let's view it in the sales quotation controller JavaScript. Here is the function. We can see that the function creates a new dialog instance and opens the dialog with initial parameters. Here are the initial parameters. If the dialog data is not empty, it will return the value in a message box. I'll change the text, which then shows me the dialog return value. Lastly, let's go to the manifest.json file. Here you can see the declaration of the dialog. It has its own ID, which is the same ID that's in the controller. In the sales quotation controller, you can find the ID of the dialog and the view of the JSON file of the dialog. In this video, you learned how to add a dialog view to a project as a custom control.